This is an easy to make 3 elements Yagi for the 2 meter band. Easy to take with you on holidays. Let's see how it comes out. This is it. Boom, made of PVC pipe, some Velcro, a hairpin match, some coax cable with a plug on it. I will demonstrate how to assemble it. In this case, I made it out of 10 mm aluminium tubing and a standard PVC pipe. So I drilled 10 mm hole in it for the director and for the reflector, and nothing for the driven element. For the driven element I made use of some clamps that you normally use to attach those PVC pipes. I put one pin in the center. It prevents that it turns over the tubing. You can click it. This tube is isolated from this tube. This was also a scrapped material. You can take what you have. The coax cable is connected directly to those elements, so the shielding to one point and the inner conductor to the other. And this is what we call a hairpin match. It makes the correct impedance. The tubing of the director and the reflector, as you can see here, when I have them here together, they have different length. The reflector is the longer one, the director is the shorter one. Just slide the aluminium through the hole, and as you can see, I made some Velcro here with a screw. You can easily attach it like this. Do the same with the other side. Just slide it in and attach the Velcro. Well, don't care how it is. It is fastened anyway. And then we can click on the driven element. We have to look for the pin, that it is in the right position. That's all, the 3 element Yagi. As you can see, this is balanced and this is unbalanced. So if you want to avoid currents, you can rotate, you can make some windings, some turns of coaxial cable around the boom. Cable is long enough. You can hold the beam in your hand. It is lightweight. You can also mount it some way on some tubing to keep it up. You can also make a kind of clamp for a balcony, as I did, made out of 2 scrapped aluminium parts, and made a pin in here that can move with a spring. And I made a hole in here So you can slide it inside till the pinch comes here. A bit difficult to see. Here the pin comes out. So now it is fastened. And you can do this on your balcony. Adjust the length here and just clamp it with Velcro again on your balcony. In this way it is vertical polarized, but you can also use it horizontal polarized, of course.
These are the dimensions of the just described three element Sciaky for the 2 meter band. I took 10 millimeter aluminum tubing because I had it. And take care, these dimensions are for an isolated setup, so a non-conducting boom. So you need to have plastic or wood as a boom. We start with a reflector at 0 centimeter, and then 39 centimeter further we have the driven element with this length, and 78 centimeter further we have this director. These dimensions are not as critical as they look. I will show you.
Dimensions of the hairpin match. 3.5 centimeter. And this is 7 centimeters.
In the simulation program Mana Gal, I simulated this antenna. And as you can see, from a frequency between 140 MHz to 150 MHz. So a lot out of band. With these dimensions, the gain is a bit changing. But it is mainly the front to back ratio that makes a lot of difference. So in fact, when you see between these frequencies, you have a gain of 8.2, 8.5, 8.8, but the front to back is 16, 19, 15. So in the 2 meter band, the front to back ratio is the best. That's also where it is designed for. However, if you have some dimensional errors, you don't have a bad antenna for the 2 meter band. To show what large dimensional errors do, I compared some changes with also some other antennas that I included. The black circle is the G antenna. It's of course round. And this is the three element Sciaky with the reflector 10 centimeter longer. And the red one is the three element Sciaky with the director 5 centimeter longer. As you can see, you have some changes, several dBs to effect, especially when you make the director 5 centimeter longer. It gives some more gain, but you have a worse front to back ratio. It depends what you prefer. However, 5 centimeter or 10 centimeter is an enormous dimensional error. So with a few millimeters or so, you don't have any problem. You can have the predicted gain and front-to-back ratio. To get an impression how the radiation pattern looks in 3D, I made this simulation. This is the reflector driven element in the director, and as you can see, a lot of energy is pointing in that direction. This is the simulation in free space. If you have the Earth here, you have, of course, another directivity with respect to the angle, to takeoff angle from Earth. So then it is pointed a bit upwards. However, I experienced with a handheld Porto that you have a lot of difference with the rubber duck that is on it. Enjoy building!